Hi friends, today we are going to learn Eclipse installation. In our earlier lesson, we have learned how to install Java and configuring it in system variables. So that is the first step for test automation. Now we need a platform to write our test automation scripts using Selenium WebDriver, and you might be using Java programming language or Python or Ruby, anything. So Eclipse is more powerful and open source platform. So let's understand. Let's download it. I just mentioned Eclipse download in the Google search. So the first result itself, the Eclipse official website, and click on the link Eclipse downloads and Eclipse foundation. So download the Eclipse technology that is right for you. Now if you just scroll down a little bit, you can see get Eclipse Photon. So this is the latest version of Eclipse, and you can directly click on this download 64-bit, but click on download packages is more preferable. Let's click on download package, because you can select the Eclipse based on your requirement. Let me show you that what are the packages available now. If you see here, so there are various Photon packages here. So Eclipse IDE for Eclipse committers and C++ developers. So we have IDE for C++ developers and for Java and DSL developers and Java developers. So there are various packages available for different development activities. Now we are going to use Java programming language, so let's download Java related IDE. Now I'm scrolling down. So there are a lot of packages here. So let me take you to Java Eclipse IDE for Java developers. So Eclipse IDE for Java developers. So every package is available for various operating systems. Now we have Windows 32 and 64-bit, and we have Macintosh, Cocoa 64-bit, and Linux 32 and 64-bit. You just take the cursor to 32-bit and 64-bit, you can able to download the related package. Now it depends on what operating system you are using. If you are using 32-bit, download, take your cursor to 32-bit and download it. If you're using 64-bit, just click on 64-bit. It will download the 64-bit related Eclipse IDE. Because I'm using 64-bit related operating system, then I'll just click on 64-bit. So it will start download, and you can see it is taking you to the downloading page where you need to download the button once again. So it is showing the server from where it is going to download. So downloading from some Japan Yamagata University. So it is connecting to that server and it is going to download. When I click on download button, so it starts downloading. So thank you for downloading. So if you see here on the left bottom corner, you can see the packages started getting downloaded. So I'm not going to download it because it's 195 MB and I already have this package available on my machine. Let me take you. So we have Selenium, Eclipse, Java, Photon, or Windows 32X. And this is a zip format. This is a zip format. What you have to do is, you have to right click here and extract this Eclipse IDE files. So there are different ways you can extract it. So you can, if you want to provide the path, so you just click on extract files, you can provide the path where you want to download. So I have already extracted the files. So let me take you. So this is the Eclipse. And if you see, there are various folders and the files, and Eclipse exe is an executable file. And just click on this, double click on this. So it will start, the Eclipse start launching. So it's going to launch Eclipse now. It takes few minutes to launch. So select, now it is prompting you to select the directory as a workspace. So what is meant by workspace here? So workspace is the place where you want to store your project artifacts. So while you're working on test automation, you might be writing, automating a lot of test scripts or test cases and writing a lot of programs, Java programs or Python programs, and you need a place to store all these program files in a certain location. So here we have to provide that place here. Let me for example, I say Selenium and tutorial is my workspace. When I click launch, it will create a Selenium tutorial folder under this Selenium WT examples. So let me show you that launch. So now the Eclipse will be launched and the workspace will be created. Whenever you launch Eclipse, so you can direct, it will show that what workspace, or if you want to switch bit, if you have more than one workspace, you can switch also. So it's loading all the files which are required for IDE. So it takes a couple of minutes to launch Eclipse. So Fortran is the very latest version. So you can see that on the, while it's launching, it's showing June 2018. So Eclipse is launched successfully. We see here, so this is the first page which will be shown when you launch it. And on the top of the right corner, you can see Workbench. If you want to go to Workbench, just click on Workbench. You can see Package Explorer, where your packages and all the artifacts, project artifacts will be shown here. And you can maintain your repository structure here. So let me go to the folder where we have, so under Selenium WD exams, I have created my Selenium tutorial. So this is my workspace here. So if you have more than one workspace, you can switch between that. So if you have, I already have one more, so I can switch to other workspace also. So this is how we can download Eclipse and launch Eclipse. And now we can start writing our scripts. We can create our project and we can start writing our test automation scripts. Thanks for watching this session. So in the next session, we will learn about how to create a project and how to create a package, create a class and start writing some scripts now. Thanks for watching this session.